Afternoon, everyone. I welcome you all to my YouTube channel. A very big thank you to all those who are subscribed. I really appreciate it. God bless you all. So today I'm going to be making a tutorial on how to cut a female pant, that's trouser. So the thing, what you need is just your trouser length, your hip measurement, your waist measurement, and your lap measurement. Then your ankle measurement, that's the bottom part of your trouser. So if you want to fold your trouser, you are going to, if it's a normal ankara, you fold it like this now. Let me show you how you are going to fold it. You are going to, so if you want to cut your trouser and the, if you want to fold it, the way you are going to fold it, assuming it's an ankara, you are going to fold it like this, which means the width to the width, that's how you are going to fold it. But since I'm not using this fabric, I just want to use it for an illustration, I'm going to fold it like this now. So what you, after folding, you are going to need your length measurement. So the next thing I will do, I'm going to insert the length measurement here now. So I'll measure what is here. So for your own, you are going to use your own trouser length measurement. So I'll be using, first of all, minus 2 inches for the down folding. The down folding of your trouser is 2 inches. You are going to minus the 2 inches first. So this is the 2 inches, you just draw it now. Then after that, now you come over now and measure your trouser length. But meanwhile, before you measure your trouser length, you are going to minus 1.5 from your trouser length, which is, let's assume now that if your trouser length is 30, if you minus 1.5, then use remaining 1 to get your full length. The reason why you are minusing is because of your band. Because you are going to be adding band to your trouser. To minus 1.5, the reason why you minus this 1.5 is this 1.5 is going to serve as your band, the band that you are going to be adding to it. So the next thing you do after removing the 1.5, so you place your tape here now at this 2 inches now, this 2 inches line, then you measure your length. So the length I will be working with, let me say 27 inches or 27 inches now. Then I will measure the 27 inches now. So you measure your length now of 27 inches, I'll be working with 27 inches. Then for your own, you are going to be using your trouser length. So please, if you are measuring your trouser length, you have to be very careful so that you won't jump after sewing. So after measuring it now, you are going to, this place now, you use your hip measurement. We are not going to be using the waist measurement to get this place. Because if you should use the waist measurement and if it's not enough, you see that you have problem with your trouser, it will not enter. So let me say now that the hip I'm working with is 32 inches now. 32 divided by 4, which is 8 now. So you add your seam allowance of 1 inches here now. But you can decide to add 1 inches, or you can decide not to add 1 inches to it, then you add it to the back. So you use your 9 inches now to measure it down to this place now. So this is the, by the time you measure this, you see that it's 9 inches now. So this is it here now. So if you want to measure your crush length now, your crush depth now, which is your flap, you divide your hip now by 4. After dividing your hip by 4, you minus, if you want the crush area to be firm for you, as in if you want, if you wear it and you want it to be tight, you minus 1.5 or 2 inches. But if you want it not, if you don't want it to be too tight, you can minus 1 inches. So, but for this aspect, I'll be removing 2 inches. So, if I minus 2 inches now from 30, which is 6 now, this is the 6 here, then I'll add extra 1 inches to my seam allowance, that's 7. So you see that, don't forget that we remove 1.5 for our band, so this is the 7 here. So under this crush length now, you insert your lap measurement. So the lap now, let me say the lap is 22 divided by 2, which is 11. If you want to divide your lap measurement is divided by 2, it's not divided by 4. So you divide it by 2 now, which is 11. This is the 11 here now, you insert your 11 here. So if you want to get your curve now, you just come up. You see that you come up by 3 or you just make it. So let me just come up by 2 now. So you curve it like this now. So this is how you are going to curve it now. So then the next thing you will do now is to come over to this place now, then minus your 1.5 now, then measure your knee. So let me say the knee measurement now is 14 inches. You measure your waist to your knee and use it to get your knee length. Then you come over to this place, now you measure on the, where this your knee is, you measure 1.5. That's for this side, not this other side. Then for this down part, now you measure the same 1.5, or you can measure 2 inches here now. If you want your trouser to be pencil, if you don't want it to be wide at the down part, that is where you'll be needing this one. But if you want it to just be wide, there's no need of measuring this one. It's just for you to insert your measurement here. But since I want it to be pencil, you just measure it like this now. Then the next thing you do, you come over to this waist area now. You mention your waist. So let me say the waist I'm working with is 27 inches. 27 divided by 4, that's 7 plus 1, which is 8. So this is the 8 now. You measure your 8 inches. Then you connect it out now. So this is how you are going to connect your trouser. So we find out that this place is too sharp. You can still blend it. You just use your shop to make it so that it will blend. It will not be too sharp. So you see, by the time that this hip is enough for you, you see that this crush now, it will enter, it will fit very well. So what you do now, you insert your knee measurement here now. So let me say the knee measurement is 13 divided by 2, which is 6.5. So this is the 6.5 plus, you can add 1 inch to your seam allowance. Then you connect it now from this place here. Then you come down to this place now and insert your ankle measurement. So the ankle measurement is 5 plus 1 inch, that's 12. So this is the 12. So if you want to measure this place now, don't just measure it straight. You measure that you slant it so that if you want to fold, you see that that place will last very well. Then the next thing is to connect everything. So you are going to measure your trouser. Measure for your trouser part. Then you come over to this upper part. If you don't have big tummy, you can leave it like this. But if it's someone that has big tummy, measure that you slant this place by 1 inch. So I don't know if you understand it. So let me just explain now. To get your flap measurement, divide your hip by 4. You can either minus 1.5 or 2 inches. If you want it to be tight, minus 2 inches. If you don't want it to be too tight, minus 1.5. So that's how you are going to get it. Then after that, under your crush length measurement, you insert your lap measurement. Lap measurement divided by 2. Then your knee measurement divided by 2. The ankle divided by 2. It's only the waist and the hip that is divided by 4. So that's how to measure your trouser. So I'm going to cut it out and use it to cut the back now. After cutting it out now, you are going to have something like this now for your trouser. But the next thing if you look at it very well, you see that this hip area now is core. You see that's how your trouser is supposed to be. If this place is okay, if this place is up to your hip measurement, you will not have problem with your crush measurement. But if it's not up to your hip measurement, by the time you wear, you see that this place is very tight. That's because it was not, the allowance was not enough. I mean, the measurement was not up to your hip measurement. That's why it's tight. So if you want to cut it, okay, so after cutting it now, you place it like this now. So get the back. You are going to place your fabric like this. But it's because my fabric is not enough for. So please know that this place now is up to, I'm going to measure, I will just mark it on this plane so that you see. For this flap area now, the allowance will be adding for the back because the back will be bigger than the front. You measure it's up to 3 inches now. So this is the 3 inches here now. Please just ignore, I just want to use this thing as an illustration. So you measure that it's up to 3 inches. Then for this other side now, you measure it to 2 inches now. You'll be adding 2 inches to it. It's only this place that you'll be adding allowance, so you'll not be adding to this other side. So you measure the 2 inches down to this other place now. So you measure it down to this place now. Then you connect it now. You connect your 3 inches now. You connect your 3 inches now like this now. To this place. Then you still make a little slant here now. Don't allow it to be straight because if it's straight, it will be very difficult if you want to sew it. So you see that this is the way it is now. Let me place this fabric here so that you see very well. Okay. Mm-hmm. So you measure it's up to 3 inches for this place now. That's for this slack area now. You measure your 3 inches now. This is the 3 inches here. You can use 3 inches or 2.5. Depends on what you want. So you just measure it and go to the shop now. Then you connect it like this now. We are going to have something like this at the back area now. So then for this this area now, this is your bumper area. Why this is your side joining. So you are going to be adding, you extend this back now by 1.5 or 2 inches. Please, if the person is hip 48 or hip 40, you can add 3 inches to this place. You can add 3 inches to this place, but for this one now, since the hip is 32, I will just add like 1.5 or 2.75. Then you connect it now to meet with this place now. You are not adding anything to this place, it's only the crush area that you will be extending. only the flush area that you'll be extending. Please just take note so that you don't make mistake of extending this other side. So this is the flush area, and you just connect it like this now. Then you can see add 1 inch to this back area. Don't know how to pronounce it, but you just extend it again. So you have something like this is how to cut your trouser. It's very simple. Let me just cut it out and then you see the picture of how it looks. So you are going to have something like this at the back now. I've already pinned it down so that it won't shift again because the fabric was not enough, so I have to pin it. So this is the front now. This is the front and this is the back. So if you want to add, if you want to insert that to your clothes, maybe you just need that fittings. What you do is just to measure now. You measure from this area now, this place now, this joining, this side joining now. You just measure like 4 inches. That's if you are from 32 34. If you are 32, you use 3.5, but if you are 38 also, you can use 4 inches depending on what you normally use for your dad. That's if you are making skirt for yourself. So you just measure it now like this now, then you measure the length. The length of your dad is 7. The normal length for that you are inserting for your trouser is 7 inches. So this is, you just make a notch here now and this place so that you'll be able to know where you are going to sew your dart or where you are going to be inserting your dart for the back and the front. So that is how you are going to insert your dart. Then for this area now, the reason why I did not add this this place, normally we normally add our flap where the zip, where we insert the zip, normally add it to it. But for this one, I want the zip to be at the back. So after sewing everything now, after joining the side and inserting your pocket, then by the time you're shaping it, you are going to, if you want to shape it, instead of shaping it and sewing it from the up, you just measure for your zip now. Let's say 7 inches or 6 inches. You just start, you mark it now, then you sew through that place. So this is where you will be inserting your zip. Or you can see inside the zip at your side joint, depending on where you want to insert it. So that's how you are going to cut it. Then if you want to cut your band, what you just need is to check your waist measurement. If your waist is 34, after shaping, you are still going to have that 34 for your trouser. So instead of 34, you just cut that like that kind of 7. You cut 7. So then the 7 that you are, instead of 34, you cut 37. So it's a 7 you are going to be cutting. The wideness, you will allow the wideness of the band to be up to 5 inches or 4.5. So then you iron your gum stay to one part. You just centralize it. Then iron gum stay to one part. Then fold it before you sew it to your trouser. That's how you are going to cut the band. Then for the pocket, if you want to cut the pocket, you are going to check how you want it, how long you want it. You can use the length of 13 inches for your pocket. 13 inches. Then the wideness of 13 inches. You can use it like that. Let's say 13 by 13. 13 for the wideness, 13 for the length. That's how you are going to cut your fabric that you'll be using for your pocket. So if you want me to make a video on how to sew pocket to your trouser, you just click it down. Comment it down in the comment box. Then I will show you how to sew your pocket. So guys, this is how to cut your trouser pant. I hope you understand. Maybe you got one or two things from it. If you don't understand it, just comment, then I will remake the video again. So guys, thank you very much for all your support. Thank you very much for your love and your care. May God bless you all. And don't forget that I love you all. And also remember that I really appreciate all your effort. And to those that are sharing our video, may God bless you all. I really appreciate. So we have come to today's tutorial. If you are not yet subscribed, please try and subscribe. And also click on the notification bell so that you'll be notified whenever we upload a new video. Thank you all. May God bless you all. Bye. Thank